So San Francisco is reporting COVID infections are skyrocketing like never before. It now has the third highest case rate in the state, but hospitalizations are relatively low. And President Biden announced the U.S. will double its order of Pfizer's antiviral pill to treat COVID-19. He also underscored the importance of the vaccine as the U.S. recorded more than 1 million new infections Monday. And the CDC is now recommending booster shots of the Pfizer vaccine 5 months after the second dose instead of 6 months.
Joining us live to talk about all of this is Dr. Abraar Karan, an infectious disease physician with Stanford Healthcare. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
We are seeing record case numbers, and practically everyone knows somebody who has tested positive for COVID. So can you put that into perspective, and when do you think we are going to see the peak of all of this?
Absolutely. I mean, we are definitely on the upswing right now. We had over a million new cases in the U.S. This is four times what it was during our previous highest numbers. And so we have wildfire spread. It's exponential. And as was noted, you know, we are seeing a dissociation between infections, hospitalizations, and people needing ventilators. So we know that our vaccines are working, but a surge of infections is a problem at any time. You don't want them all coming at the same time.
Right. It's scary to hear all those numbers. You mentioned hospitalizations. They are ticking up, but not where they were in that first winter surge that we all brutally remember. How concerned are you about this strain on the healthcare system with Omicron?
I am concerned, and one of the biggest concerns I have is spread of the virus within hospitals, because we know that people who are immunocompromised, who have many health conditions, who are hospitalized for other things, can also contract COVID when they're in the hospital. And so when you have a lot of visitors coming in or even healthcare workers getting infected, hospitals need to ramp up preventing infections occurring in the hospital. That's one of the things I am very concerned about.
So the CDC is shortening the time frame on when to receive the booster shot from 6 months to 5 months after that second shot. Can you explain a little bit the reasoning behind that? And do you see it making a big difference in getting those vaccination rates up?
Yeah, so the explanation here is that as more time passes from your last shot, the efficacy of the vaccine against infections definitely wanes, and against severe disease wanes, but a little bit less than that. So your chance of getting infected is higher the longer you've been since your last shot. So this is the time we need to ramp it up, get people those booster shots that can also help people prevent testing positive and prevent passing it on. It won't stop it completely, but it will reduce the chance, and that matters.
And I understand when you get that third shot, that booster shot, your immunity spikes pretty quickly right after you get it, correct?
Correct. You know, over the course of a few days and really into a couple of weeks is where you'll really get that good immune response boosted up. And then over time, even that will wane. But for now, I think the focus really needs to be on we're in the surge. We need to get the booster to as many people as possible, especially those who are at high risk of progression.
Right. All right. Today, the CDC updated its guidance after coming under pressure for cutting the quarantine time in half to 5 days from 10. Now says people can take a rapid test if they want after those 5 days. Do you think that that's still sufficient, or are we going to get some issues where they're still contagious?
Well, you will definitely have people who are still contagious past the five-day mark, which is why CDC says wear a mask for those next 5 days after. Now, if you have a negative rapid antigen test, it means that you're not extremely contagious, because if you had a positive test, many times that correlates with someone that's very contagious still. Mm-hmm. And so I think it would help to reduce people who are very contagious from going out in the community. But wearing a mask, particularly a high filtration mask, like an N95, KF94, that is actually better source control. It means you're not going to be spreading as much virus out from your mouth, even when you are infectious. So that's going to be really important.
So no more of those little cloth cute masks or little thin slabs of cloth there.
No, we have to step up. I mean, it's been 2 years. We can't be relying on cloth masks. I mean, this is a medical emergency. We need to have medical grade masks on people. This would really be important for stunning transmission.
Okay, so even the surgical mask, so that's okay. The one you get at Walgreens and stuff, but you don't necessarily.
So if you get a surgical mask, the fit is key. So you can do things like sort of use a hair tie to even pull the mask tighter behind your ears, or to twist it and put it over your ears. Ideally, you can get a mask fitter that actually goes over the surgical mask and gets you a really good seal, because those surgical masks are actually still made with very good filtration material, but you get a lot of leakage.
Okay, got great tips. All right, Dr. Karan, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me.